You might be wondering what exactly it means if your thyroid nodule is classified as TIRADS 5. When a thyroid nodule is labeled TIRADS 5, it means the ultrasound found features that are highly suspicious for thyroid cancer. But remember, it does not confirm cancer. It simply tells us that we need to take a closer look, usually with a biopsy, to be sure. Even though TIRADS 5 nodules are concerning, many still turn out to be benign after biopsy. It's a guide for careful evaluation, not a final diagnosis. You may also wonder why your nodule was specifically classified as TIRADS 5. It's because on the ultrasound, your nodule showed features that raise concern. These include being completely solid, very dark compared to normal thyroid tissue, having irregular or jagged edges, containing tiny bright spots of calcium, or being shaped taller than it is wide. You might also wonder when a suspicious nodule actually needs a biopsy. For TIRADS 5 nodules, the general recommendation is to do a biopsy if the nodule measures 1 centimeter or larger. This ensures that important nodules are investigated early enough to guide proper care. If your nodule is smaller than 1 centimeter, you might be asking if you still need a biopsy. In many cases, the answer is no, unless there are additional concerning signs like hoarseness, a strong family history of thyroid cancer, or rapid growth of the lump. Otherwise, careful ultrasound monitoring is usually the best course. You may also be wondering how soon you should schedule the biopsy. While a TIRADS 5 nodule deserves attention, it's not considered an emergency. Most doctors recommend scheduling the biopsy within a few weeks to a couple of months. Understandably, many patients ask if the biopsy is painful or dangerous. The good news is thyroid fine needle aspiration is a very quick, safe, and well-tolerated procedure. Most people describe only mild discomfort, similar to a blood test. If you're wondering what happens if the biopsy comes back benign, that's great news. If benign, no surgery is needed. Your doctor will recommend regular follow-up ultrasounds just to make sure the nodule remains stable over time. On the other hand, what happens if the biopsy does find suspicious or malignant cells? In that case, surgery is usually recommended. Depending on your situation, it may involve removing just part of the thyroid or the entire thyroid if necessary to ensure full treatment. Sometimes patients ask, what if the biopsy result isn't clear? This can happen. Your doctor may suggest repeating the biopsy, sending the sample for molecular testing, or moving to surgery based on your overall risk factors. Another common question is how reliable TIRADS 5 is at predicting cancer. TIRADS 5 nodules have a higher cancer risk, about 20 to 75%, depending on different studies. But remember, some nodules still turn out to be benign. That's why the biopsy remains essential. You might also wonder if a suspicious nodule could shrink or disappear on its own. It's very unlikely. Most suspicious nodules either stay the same size or grow slowly over time. That's why monitoring is important even when surgery isn't immediately needed. If your nodule is smaller and doesn't meet the size for biopsy, you may ask, what's next? In this case, your doctor will recommend careful observation, usually with repeat ultrasounds every 6 to 12 months, to check for any changes. After a benign biopsy, it's natural to wonder how often you will need checkups. Usually, the first follow-up ultrasound is done 6 to 12 months after the biopsy. If the nodule remains stable, the follow-up intervals can become longer over time. Patients often ask what symptoms they should watch for. Stay alert for a hoarse voice, trouble swallowing, a lump that seems to grow, or pressure in your neck. If you notice any of these, it's important to contact your doctor promptly. It's reasonable to ask if blood tests can detect whether a nodule is cancerous. The answer is no. Blood tests only tell us how well your thyroid is functioning, not whether a nodule is cancerous. That's why ultrasound and biopsy are so important. If you have several thyroid nodules, you might wonder if that affects your risk. Each thyroid nodule is evaluated individually. Even if most nodules look harmless, a TIRADS 5 nodule still needs focused attention and biopsy. If surgery becomes necessary, you may ask if you will lose your entire thyroid. The answer depends. Sometimes only the affected lobe is removed. Other times, if there's concern about spread, the entire thyroid may need to be removed for complete treatment. Thank you so much for spending your time with us today. We hope that this calm, clear walkthrough has made the idea of a TIRADS 5 thyroid nodule a little less overwhelming. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe to our channel and share it with anyone who might need clear, caring health information. Take care, stay informed, and we'll see you again soon with more easy-to-understand health topics.